I was hooked up to so many machines that night that everything beeped, and I just had nothing to do but think about, am I going to get through this and wake up in the morning, you know? It was congestive heart failure due to the chemo that I had received in 2008. I went through 6 months of very intense chemo. I recovered from all that and was living normally. It was a relief to be done with everything I went through and know that I could get back to normal and had another grandchild, so I had more of them to play with. And
patients that have been exposed to chemotherapy can manifest signs of heart disease as late as 15 and 20 years after their exposure. It causes the heart muscle to overdose on calcium, which causes the heart muscle to potentially break down and burst.
The first thought that went through my head is, I'm gonna beat this. I beat cancer. I'm gonna beat this.
After about 6 months, we found that her heart function had not dramatically improved, and her heart remained very enlarged. I started to talk to her about this really new and exciting clinical trial.
So this clinical trial focused on patients who survived cancer, and following the cancer treatment, they developed heart failure symptoms. We wanted to look at the effects and the benefits of a new device that is called cardiac resynchronization therapy. So when you look at the heart here, it's not pumping at the same time. It's very inefficient. It creates heart failure.
We try to have both sides of the heart working better together.
I went the next day and they implanted it, kept me all night, and let me come home.
6 months later, the heart is pumping much more effectively and in a much more synchronized way.
Her heart size had returned back to normal.
I feel great. I can do my stairs. I work out at the gym 3 days a week.
And this gives hope for them. It gives encouragement for them to re-engage with life and live it to the fullest.